I'm attorney Pat Dunn. Auto accidents are a part of life. I hope you never need an attorney, but if you do, the team at the Mack Law Firm is here to help.
We're back at Martha Vineyard in Ponchatoula, where, like across the nation, it's National School Lunch Week with Principal Melissa Ryan. And always this occasion here creates a lot of excitement.
Yes, we love to celebrate our lunch ladies. They do an awesome job serving our school lunches, and the children like to get excited about it. Miss Annie likes to get excited about it, and we like to be able to, be here to kind of show off what we do every day with our students.
Now, when you say we like to celebrate, I mean, this whole lunchroom is a celebration right now.
Yes, it truly is. Miss Annie has redecorated and kind of turned us into Bourbon Street.
More so than the real Bourbon Street these days.
Yes, for sure. And it has been kind of sad this year because the children have been eating in the classroom due to COVID safety concerns. But we're excited to hopefully next year have them back in our cafeteria.
Matter of fact, school lunches are something we can no longer take for granted because for quite a while we didn't have them.
Right. The students are kind of are liking the new system because they kind of feel like they're getting room service. They get everything delivered to them to the classroom. They have little boxes with their lunch served in it, and they get to choose a different dessert or a different vegetable to go with it. So they're not too sad about being in the classroom.
By the way, logistically, has it been a problem? Because it sounds like quite an undertaking.
It has been really tough on our lunch ladies and gentlemen. They've done just an amazing job getting the lunches out to everyone.
Well, during the pandemic, we've all been reminded of just how important school lunches can be, especially to underprivileged kids.
Yes, absolutely. So we're excited that actually our numbers are kind of up because they're getting delivered to the classroom, and some of the students who normally would never have eaten the school lunch, they're seeing what the other kids are eating. So they're like, oh, I want to try it too. So we are getting more kids to eat their lunch.
Well, that's really incredible. You'd never think that.
Yeah, they're really enjoying it.
So tell us something about school lunches that people wouldn't think about.
Well, sometimes people think that our school lunches aren't nutritional, but they are very nutritional. They have to follow very strict guidelines with the lunches. So some people kind of think that they're just feeding them a bunch of processed food, but they're really feeding them really good lunches. And when we have hot meals, when we have gumbo, when we have baked chicken and macaroni and cheese, it's always piping hot. Miss Annie and her ladies do a great job of waiting till right before lunchtime to get it out to all the classes. They get it there quickly, and they're just doing an amazing job.
Well, again, a lot of kids, and this is bad, but what can we do about it? They depend on school lunches and, for that matter, breakfasts for most of their nutrition.
Yes, they really do. And breakfast is also, our breakfast numbers are up because we deliver breakfast to the classroom and we're not really sure how many kids are going to be there each morning and the breakfast is there waiting on them. So we bring enough for every child in the class. So kids who normally maybe not would have come to the cafeteria because they don't want to miss morning recess to eat breakfast, it's there waiting on them. So almost everyone's eating breakfast in the morning.
Well, I would ask, what's next or what's the situation here at Martha Vineyard? But I imagine that, like the other Ponchatoula schools, overcrowding is one of the big things.
Yes, we really are. We have a lot of virtual students. We have about 130 virtual students, so that's helping us to not be too overcrowded, but we still have classrooms at 24 students in the class.
Looking at the growth in Bedeco, the growth in some other areas, why, I don't think that overcrowding will get any better anytime soon.
No, we don't look toward it to get any better, but we're just hoping that the school tax will pass and we'll get some additional funds into our system so that we can hopefully do some extra things to help our students be successful.
What else is new here at Martha Vineyard?
Martha Vineyard, not much new, just getting our students prepared for LEAP. We want to make sure that they feel successful and they feel confident in themselves. We've been doing a lot of work with our Chromebooks, the students working them every day. They've been doing an amazing job of not only working in their Chromebooks every day, but also getting away from that screen also and doing some collaboration with their classmates face-to-face.
It takes more than one person to assist in a personal injury claim. I am attorney Glenn Westmoreland, and we have a strong team at the Mack Law Firm. It is our goal to make sure your injury is properly attended to. Contact me at tangylawteam.com and let us get you the help you need.